Hi everybody, my name is April Monroe and welcome to another video. So this is the third and final video on releasing your spinal column when it's gone into spasm. Once more, we're going to go a little bit deeper, but all of these poses in these three videos will help you to keep your spine healthy, strong, long, and keep you out of pain. So, we are going to start with just a little bit of breath work, and then we'll go from there. I'd like you to close your eyes and begin to breathe in and out through the nose, unless it is uncomfortable. As you're breathing, place the tip of the tongue to the roof of the mouth, slightly back from your front teeth. You'll notice the rasping bones as the breath passes over the tongue. And I'd like you to listen to that noise, as it will help to still your mind and your body. As you breathe in, fill up the tummy, fill up the lungs, and notice how the collarbone lifts. As you exhale, notice the softening of the collarbone and the chest and the tummy. And if your mind wanders off, let the thoughts go and always come back to that sound and that feeling of your breath. And then when you're ready, open your eyes, come back to the room. When your back has gone into spasm, you tend to be able to find that sitting on the floor is the easiest place to be. So that's why all of these last three videos have been on the floor. It's okay to sit on cushions and blocks and anything you need. And in this class, we are going to start with child's pose. Rest back, sending the bottom to the heels, but never worry if the bottom doesn't touch the heels, it's just tension in the back, hamstrings or thighs. Drift forwards with the head, don't worry if the head doesn't touch the floor. And it's up to you if the arms are out long, or you draw the arms into the sides of the body. And just take some very slow, deep breaths. You might want to send the breath And there's nothing wrong with just gently massaging the area if that's where you're in pain. And you can hold this for anywhere from a minute to 3 minutes. Next one we're going to do is seated cobbler, and then from seated cobbler we're going to go into soles of feet. Okay. You're going to sit on your sit bones, but it's okay to sit on a cushion or more, or yoga books or more. Okay. But always be on the sit bones. Knees bent in front of you. Knees and feet together. Let the knees drop out to the sides. And I would definitely take the hands behind you. Okay. And my hands are facing behind me. If you don't like that position, turn the fingers out to the sides instead. Okay. Now, I know my feet are in the wrong position, so I'm just going to draw my feet in. And there's roughly a full hand length between the pubic bone and the heels of my feet. And I'm just going to give my legs a little bit of a jiggle. Gaze is soft, jaw is relaxed, chin is slightly nodded under. And I'm just going to push down with equal measure into both legs. And that's going to work your adductor muscles, which get really, really tight when the spine has gone into spasm. It's to do with the psoas muscle tightening. Be really gentle. Never worry if the legs don't go all the way to the floor. And when the back is in spasm, you might find your knees are up here and you've just got to work from that angle, being very gentle with yourself. You also may notice that one knee is higher than the other, and that is perfectly normal. Don't think you're strange. Keep relaxing on the exhale. Jiggle the legs as and when necessary. And again, holding that for a minute to 3 minutes, easing off at any time you wish. Ready to ease off the pose, relax the legs, and bring hands forwards so that they're just cupping the toes. Always make sure you're using lots and lots of core control and pelvic floor. Now, we're going to go into soles of feet, and when the spine has gone into spasm, it tightens around the sacrum. Sometimes you feel it into the glutes, so you've got sciatica. More often than not, you feel it right here in the adductors and into the groin. It's because all those muscle groups are connected. So you might get here and think, I can't go any further, the pain is really intense, and that's fine. Just stay here and keep relaxing the legs. Close your eyes and really engage with the breath. And then, as the back begins to release, what you'll be able to do is exhale and begin to drape forwards. So the spine is rounding. The elbows are bent and going over the shins, and the head is broken down towards the feet, hence why it's called soles of feet. Now what you might find, if you're just getting out of that spine being in spasm, is you will feel a pull right here into the hips, right here in the top of the sacrum. And you've just got to breathe and relax into that area. Eventually it eases off. You can go deeper. But be careful. Don't tear the muscle groups. Use the breath and stay relaxed. And as the head gets all the way down to the feet, but it might not do so at first. You can ease off the pose at any time. Jiggle the legs. Deep breath in and go back into it. To release the pose, and you want to feel like the spine is unfurling and stacking and the head coming up last. Don't worry how close you get to the feet or not. Just keep using the exhaled breath to release the muscle groups. Then when you're out of the pose, take the legs out long and give the legs a really good shake. So from here, we're going to go into an intense Western forward fold. But I have modified this so that it's going to release the sacrum, the spine, and the tops of the hamstrings. Okay. So be on the sit bones, whether you're on the mat as I am, or you're sat on cushions or blocks. Feet are roughly hip distance apart. And keep feet relaxed. Bend the knees. Okay. So not too deeply bent, but enough for me to roll over the front of the sit bones and place the tummy and the chest upon the thighs. Arms are relaxed. Head just dropping down, jaw relaxed, and I'm closing my eyes. And you can just stay in this position for 1 minute to 3 minutes. But you might get here and think, actually, my back is really, really given. So you might want to begin to straighten the legs just a little bit. Just to encourage a stretch, a deeper stretch. Keep relaxing on the exhale. Notice where you're feeling any tension. Again, if the stretch wears off, you could take the slightly further up the mat, but tummy, chest, still in contact very slightly with the thighs. So you're really working into the sacrum and the muscles here in the base of the spine. It's just being about as gentle and as careful as you possibly can to turning extended muscles and getting out of pain. And you can work to straight legs if you want to, but spine might not go that far at first. Okay. So when you're ready to come out of it, slide the hands up the legs and up the floor and feel the spine stack. Roll the shoulders and give the legs a little bit of a shake. Well done. So from here, I'm just going to go into child's pose for a few deep breaths, and that will be the end of this short video. So very slowly, I'm just coming back into that all fours position, resting back towards the heels, head draping down, up to you if you keep the arms out long. Hold your other arms in. These three videos really, really help you to maintain your spine health. If you've enjoyed this one, please like and don't forget to subscribe. Thank you.